Mass surveillance in combination with social credit score is one of the hot topics for 2021. In this video, I show how it works behind the scenes. You will learn how the system operates and how you can remain undetected.
Damn, it feels good to be a gangster.
If you are not convinced yet that mass surveillance is coming to where you live, and you are under the impression that this future belongs only to post-apocalyptic science fiction movies, this video is not for you. I have a lot to say, and I didn't make this video to waste anyone's time. I'm not spending energy on explaining what should already be obvious. I made this video in order to educate those who understand the reality we live in, and want to prepare themselves for what is about to be part of our lives. For people with no background in computer programming, terms like artificial intelligence and facial recognition may sound like black magic. But as I will show you in this video, these systems are far from being perfect, and there are many flaws that can be exploited when this technology is applied. Let's start with a brief description of social credit score. The idea is to have a lot of cameras that will record 24/7 and monitor everyone's behavior. The actions of each person will be documented and the person will get points when they are being obedient. Or they will lose points when acting in an undesired way according to the authorities. There are a few things that the government needs in order to implement this idea. First of all, they must have cameras everywhere. Throughout 2020, there were cameras installed all over the world, especially in heavily populated areas. So you could say that this task was completed. Along with the cameras, there has to be a strong infrastructure to support this massive transfer of data. The 5G internet takes care of that. Smart cities have fast and stable internet everywhere. The fact that there are cities with a big number of smart devices that communicate with the internet proves that this infrastructure already exists. In order to identify people, the cameras send the data to a center that has a software that performs facial recognition. And this is the part where it becomes more complicated for the government. To explain how facial recognition works, I will use Facebook as an example. Facebook's facial recognition system is based on a deep learning method called convolutional neural network. Although facial recognition is relatively a new field, the theory behind convolutional neural networks exists since the 80s. And unlike what the mainstream news brainwashed the masses to believe, there are a lot of disadvantages to this method of machine learning. Before I cover the ways to trick this system, let me explain how it works. For Facebook to be able to recognize a face in a photo, it needs to study how this face looks like. This requires many photos, so if you only uploaded one photo with your face shown clearly, Facebook will probably not be able to identify you in other photos. With every photo, the system learns a bit how you look like. The learning mechanism of the neural network is called hidden layers, and it is considered a black box since no one knows what formulas the computer uses in order to produce the output, which in this case means the identity of a person. Although some researchers believe that the space between your eyes is the most crucial part of your face for the system to be able to recognize you. After completing its calculations, the network produces a matrix with the match percentage between the input and every person it is compared to. As I said, the science of convolutional neural networks existed back in the 80s, The reason that facial recognition only now being implemented everywhere is that a system such as this demands hardware requirements that were not met until the second decade of the 21st century. So if you are old enough to remember when Facebook started asking users to tag themselves and other people in photos, this was the motivation behind it. If you saw Facebook trying to guess who is the person in the photos with their suggestions, maybe you also noticed that there are many mistakes. This is because the network was not fed with enough data, and it always continues to learn. The way Facebook searches for a match is not within its entire database of users, but only the people that a user is more likely to take a photo with. In other words, their friends list. This is called search range, and I will explain why this is important in a second. The social credit score is already implemented in China, and it is pretty successful from the government's perspective. But that doesn't mean that the system is proof and doesn't make false identifications. In my opinion, the Chinese population is extremely obedient, and that makes life easier for the Chinese authorities. Social credit score will not work with a big enough number of citizens who know how to trick the system and actively try to test it. Here are some ways to mess with facial recognition AI. The images that are being used as input always display faces in a straight angle. Turning your head to the side will confuse the system that tries to identify you. Covering parts of your face that are important for identification, such as the space between your eyes, can also help avoid detection. And how does a mass surveillance system work in practice? Since the AI is not perfect, mass surveillance cannot be fully automated. There has to be someone sitting behind the screen and backtracking your movements to confirm the results. The camera sends video to a computer that analyzes it, and the computer outputs the results with some percentage of certainty that the person in the video is you. Since it is used in a heavily populated area, there may be other candidates who the system identifies as possible matches. In order to optimize this system, the candidates will not be taken out of huge databases. Otherwise, the computers will have to perform a huge amount of calculations. This will result in long waiting times until the network finishes, and too many false identifications. A system like that cannot be considered a good system. This is why the search of the system will have to be somehow limited by a search range. This range will include only the people who live in an area or have a justified reason to be there. The area will be surrounded by police checkpoints, and movement from one area to another will either not be permitted or it will be permitted and documented. Another way to limit the search range is to have a list of people in the area using their GPS coordinates. Your location can be retrieved in a couple of ways from your smartphone or any other device that transmits signals. So, as I said before, social credit score cannot be implemented in a society that is completely disobedient. Listen to how you can fool facial recognition systems and use this knowledge so we do not end up like China. The way authorities identify their citizens heavily relies on social media. If you already uploaded photos to your online accounts, deleting them now won't help. If you want to make it more difficult for them, you could edit photos of your face and upload the modified pictures of yourself to your social media accounts. Doing so will feed the neural network with bad input, and that will be followed by bad output, making it more time-consuming for them to identify you. If you go somewhere and you do not wish to be tracked, do not take a device that constantly sends live feedback of your location. If you really have to take your smartphone with you, it is possible to deactivate its signals by taking out its battery or by putting it inside a Faraday cage where it cannot transmit any signals. If you remember what I said earlier about the system's search range, you can get to the conclusion that staying in an area where you are not supposed to be in will make it more difficult to find you. Just keep in mind that once you are found, you may get your name added to a list of troublemakers for future reference. Backtracking your moves will be extremely difficult if you change your clothes. Leaving your house with a t-shirt and putting on a jacket while you are traveling in public transportation will make course identifications using different cameras in remote locations cost a lot of resources to those who want to track you down. And as I mentioned before, covering parts of your face is also helpful when trying to go undetected. So you could wear a hat or find another creative way to practice this advice. Enough people acting this way will be exhaustive to the operators of mass surveillance systems and will make it impossible for the government to impose social credit score. Let's not become China.